The boat so small. They look like 20 feet like this, and then long about 80, 90 feet. That boat for people, they go fishing nearby the shore, about like 6-8 miles. But the owner who sell that boat for us, they put some wood, little high for look like a good boat. But when I get in the boat at midnight, in the end of the South Vietnam, they call like Ca Mau, something like that. And then when the morning sun shine, I look, oh God, it's not the boat go through the ocean, just on the shore, but you have no choice. Police from communists, yeah. They run after, try to catch me up. But with me, I understand one way to go. Because the wave was high that time, but I thought I just go straight to the high. That means you go to suicide. It's not go safety. Because you know the rule, the law, the technical when you run in the ocean. But have no choice. If you don't go this way, they go over, catch you up, you done. They don't stop but go with us because we are one way to go, freedom or die. So that I go straight and then I told people, okay. People say, you crazy. Why you go straight to the way to high? I say, no, we have no choice. Go. If you want to
straight into the wave.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Go straight.
Right into the wave.
Yep. When we are touching international the ocean, we got the Thailand fishing, but the big boat looked like a Navy boat. So I look over there, I saw one old man about 50 some years, the boy about 10 years. And I surprised, I say, this time the private very danger. Why they got a small, little children on the boat, I said, that's a good boat. So I try to give them a signal, need help, like SOS, something like that. They come over. Mm-hmm. They come over, and then they ask us, I say, we looking for freedom. We cannot live with the communists. So then they say, okay, we help you. But you got anything like the gold or people ring with, give to them. They took a compass, they took the map, yep, anything. And then they poor children get in the boat. When sunset, and then the wave were so hard, bow, bow, and I think, no. Only me in the boat. I say, no, I can't. I think myself, I can. If I stay over here later on, I should be die. So I ask someone in the boat, give me a chance go on the boat. And he say, why? I say, oh, I can't handle because I need to practice because mm-hmm. on what 5 days in. He say, okay, get you in. So I get on board and then half hour, the boat sink.
It did.
They sing. I'm lucky. So they sailor go in and they use a big prop, all of this. They tie up, they try to sail the boat, but can't. The boat sing. And then they cut off the prop and sing. Thank you. But that time, the system not like perfect like now. So they give you a chance to go outside to labor work. And then when you go on the streets, so people get like a farmer market. Okay, so the people, they know you are from South Vietnam, so they love you, but they can sell for the grass come with you every day, but they try connect with you when the guy leave you a chance stop to buy the foods, and then you connect with them and they help you. One day they set up like they, you go come over buy the food or exchange the thing with the food, and they let you know. And then that time you have no choice because you know people love you, they give you a chance because you in the prison, in the camp, you have no chance, no connect. Because I on you 24 hours. So then I think that time I say, wow, the will of heaven. So try it. So I take the offer from them. So they transfer house by house quickly. And then get you to the bus station. They set up already and then they give you a chance to get in the bus, the bus go. So that means I understand from that time until I get in the boat, I know my life give to the God. So God save me. That's what I understand. If some people, they say no God, no. They don't understand the power of the universal.